This is really for the sad cases of church. People who are very confused about sexuality. People like the Pope of Canterbury, who's just launched an Anglican discussion where they're going to take 3 years to try and iron out a statement from the judge on the grounds of sexuality. See, the Anglican, the Pope of Canterbury actually believes that sodomites, for instance, as God calls them, are valid people. Well, actually, they're not God's people at all, any more than murderers or adulterers or politicians and popes and paedophiles. They're not God's people. There's two peoples on the earth, God's people and Satan's people, and Satan's camp is by far the biggest camp. And now here we are at that time, as prophesied by Daniel, and I can't remember where it is, where the sheer hordes of Satan have overwhelmed the camp of the saints, and Christians no longer rule the earth. So here we have the Anglican religion trying to discuss what sexuality is all about, having brought in rebel women to speak and be ministers and what have you, in defiance of God, who says quite plainly that through Paul, I permit not a woman to teach nor usurp authority over a man, but to be in silence. And now they're talking about sexuality, whether the government position of homosexuality is to be rewarded and stuff, or whether they're going to take God's position that it's to be punished. Now, a quick read of the book of Leviticus should show you that the law of Almighty God, who the Anglicans and church people are supposed to be in the good of, says quite plainly, all sex outside marriage is capital crime. Can we just, for those of you not heard me speak about this before, the Lord God of Israel's created order before the fall, before the temptation and the fall of mankind in the Garden of Eden, was utterly pure and holy. And his way is one man, one woman, together for life, chastity before wedding, fidelity within marriage. The law of God says quite plainly, if a boy or a girl and a girl who are virgins go and have sex together, once they're discovered, the boy is forced to take the girl to be his wife. Not that they're forced to marry, because they already are married. The spiritual bond between a man and a woman takes place in sex. Sex is marriage. The weddings, all invented by men, ceremonies, vows, rings, and prancing pagans in frocks in pointy shed clubhouses, and we saw one the other day as we were driving along, my wife and I, just as the bride with father in a Rolls Royce arriving at the church. The weddings invented by men, and the gowns, and the, you know, the dressing up and the reception is entirely the invention of men. The Lord God never ordained any of that whatsoever. This comes from a season when the abominable befrocked dared take control of the things and the ways of God, taking control of who's going to marry who and all the rest of it. But sex is marriage. That's why if a girl or a boy goes, a girl goes whoring or a boy goes fornicating and he sex with more than one person, the law of God says what? Well, the law of God says they should be executed. Now, please, let's all remember that there is no confusion here. So there's no confusion. There's two camps of people on the earth. God's people, to whom the law of God does apply, but it's applied differently today, and the vast bulk Satan's people. But unfortunately, we have a system in the UK where notably the abominable befrocked of the past, before the power of Satan's church religion was broken with the Reformation and the Catholics' light inserted between the Catholic Christian killing Catholics and the actual Christians, what they did was take the things of God, own written to, for and about God's people, and impose them on those who were not God's people to start with. What on earth are you doing? People talk about, oh, the moral compass of the country has been completely lost. These people are, oh dear, they're sleeping together rather than marrying. I'm terribly sorry, but sex is marriage. And if you've had sex with more than one person, you're married to more than one person, and that's why the law of God says execution. The spiritual confusion behind the actions of you being spiritually bonded with more than one person is what the issue is. Not the physical union primarily, it's the spiritual thing that's the behind the scenes that causes that. Hence also other celebrity type behaviour. Or putrid politician type behaviour, adultery is capital crime, isn't it? We don't have to get to deep cesspit stuff for that. So here we have the abominable befrocked of the satanic state religion of Anglicanism, bastard child of the evil cult of Rome, actually pontificating on the basis of things they've learned in a university somewhere. There's some professor woman they're going to be adding into this debate. Playing God. Now, what are they doing? From Isaiah 14, 15, whatever it is, talking about Satan. 14, I'm sure it is. Where Satan says, I will exalt my throne above the stars of God. I will be like the Most High. In other words, he wanted to be a god and argue with God. And here the satanic cult of Anglicanism is actually arguing against the Lord God of Israel, saying that they have the right to vary the will, the truth and the way of God. Now, you and I know full well that actually they're not God's people. They're pagans, just like Hindus or Sikhs, Buddhists, Muslims, Jews, or Catholics or whatever, Orthodox and all the rest of it, and they are still in their arrogant pride. Now, but what would you and I do? You and I fear crossing his line, don't we? Because his law still stands. Jesus said not one jot or tittle would pass from the law till all things be fulfilled. We can't have a 1,000-year reign of Jesus Christ without a benchmark for his rulership. And the benchmark for his rulership will be the law of God. And come Judgment Day in stage one of judgment, most people, he sorts the sheep from the goats and the goats are dispensed with into the lake of fire. But stage two of judgment, you and I stand there, God's people. And it's God's way in the new covenant way, which is applied to us. But unfortunately, I think we're going to see lots of people like this. Now, we can fall into this hole, you and I. You see, because if we descend into the pit of trying to vary the will and the way of our Lord and arguing, debating and disputing like people I know do, you destroy everything. Because you see, if you, just by dint of some degree from some hideous sump called a university somewhere, think you have power over God to vary what he says, you communicate to everybody that's listening to you or that you are leading, like the Anglican religion, that God is so weak and pathetic, wretched human beings can vary his will and his way according to their will by dint of the power of their paedophile frock. And you immediately destroy faith in your hearers. You set yourself above God and you state by your actions, Satan is greater than God and we are Satan's people and we're going to have it our way. You are saying, you are showing yourself that you are just like Satan. That you are with Satan. That you are going to exalt your throne above the stars of God and be like him, like the Most High. And you can debate and argue with God and vary his will according to your will. You destroy your own image. You reduce God to appearing to be utterly, totally pathetic. And people won't take any notice of you because your God isn't worth bothering with, surely. So, you know, we all please, you know, you and I who are saved, we all understand that the Anglicans are not Christians at all. They're nominal Christians. They're no better than a bunch of Hindus or Catholics or Buddhists, Sikhs, Jews or whatever. And it's only by the grace of God that we can see and that we're in the good of these things. Okay. And, you know, none of us is pointing fingers and condemning them. They can't help it. And, you know, slapping them around and trying to get them into the right place is about as daft as slapping a man around because he's male. He can't help it. It's just how they are, you know. However, let you and I not be sucked into this. Let's not get into this idea that you and I can vary the will, the truth, and the way of God in any detail. If you do, as the Lord God says quite plainly, walk in the Spirit, walk after the Spirit. If we walk in the light as he is in the light, the blood of Jesus Christ cleanses us from all sin and we have fellowship one with another. Or the other way around. But if we want to walk in darkness, then we will become arrogant and start arguing with God and telling God how it's going to be on his earth while you breathe his air. Can I submit to you that that is a wee bit dangerous? You're not dealing with some puffy person in the sky, you know. This person owns you. So let's all pay attention now. This is serious, serious stuff, and there are horrors going on out there. The law of God still stands. Oh, its application has radically changed, yes. But his standards haven't. And the law still stands and is extant. And it will be the standard for his thousand-year reign. Jesus' thousand-year reign in a little while time. We're going to see Satan soon, I'm sure. But when he comes, he'll be reigning. There won't be any disputes about sexuality then, will there?